Oh, you must try my ale sometime. You must. My abbey brews the best in Kent.
It certainly sounds worth the risk of my immortal soul.
Ah, your god is rather a hard taskmaster.
And your god forbids the mixing of wool and linen. It sounds to me like he's never heard of England.
Not all that is written in the scriptures is God's honest truth.
I do a roaring trade at Reculver and Tunbridge. They pay well for my catch.
The monks? Do those parchment-skinned Christians ever eat meat?
Don't you believe in Jesus? They refrain because he died for our sins.
No one will stop me sucking the marrow from a nice leg of lamb, not even God's seed.
Well, I hope eternal damnation is worth it.
One more time, I'm telling you. If he says my boots are dirty or my hair needs combing, I will split him open.
You're full of swamp gas. You'll do what you always do, bow and scrape to our good Thane Tedmund.
I'm not even sure it's him we're working for.
Don't be daft. Who else would it be?
A changeling spirited there by fairy folk.
Get back to patrol.
Eivor, you have news?
Kent's new elderman will be Thane Tedmund.
Tedmund? Oh, the Lord is testing me. He is made mouse by you Danes. Barely leaves his fortress at Rusister. How might I gain his influence if he will not speak to me? Or to anyone? Tis a puzzle.
To inspire loyalty, Tedmund must owe you something. Such is his life.
Go on.
A fortress stormed. A man kidnapped. If you beat back his enemy, saved him from sure death, his gratitude would be...
Swell. It would know no bounds. But that fortress will be harder to pry open than a nun's knees.
Perhaps. Perhaps not.
Are you hiding something, Basim?
There is a lumber mill nearby, correct?
Beamersfield. Alfred invests much in fortifying Wessex, and uses our forests to do so. The mill provides his wood.
Tedmund is there.
Impossible! How do you know?
I heard rumors that Tedmund had been lured out of self-exile to manage work on the fortifications of Canterbury.
Taking him from a lumberyard is less dangerous than assaulting a fortress. But your rescue attempt will not have the same flair. Is it worth it?
It may still work. Yes. Yes. Bring him to the megaliths.
And Fulke?
When I have Tedmund's fealty, you shall have Fulke. Now go. I will rustle up a small rescue party.
I'm wary of this abbot, Basim. He is self-serving and evasive. Can he really deliver Fulke?
The abbot is a friend of Fulke's. That is clear.
So long as he doesn't suspect our motive, we may have a chance.
Indeed. This brings to mind a story. Perhaps you've heard of it. The Scorpion and the Frog.
A children's story?
A cautionary tale. The Scorpion wants to cross the river, but he cannot swim. So he enlists the help of the Frog. The Frog agrees to carry him on his back, extracting a promise that the Scorpion will not sting him.
Let me guess. The Scorpion reneges, blaming his nature, and both drown.
The Scorpion crosses the river and stings an innocent man, killing him. So what does this tale tell us?
That your stories are clouded, and their meaning doubly so?
It shows that every tale has 1,000 possible outcomes, many of which are surprising. If the abbot does not deliver Fulke, you will die at my hand. And we will continue our search.
A sobering approach.
Ah!
Bemisfield is just ahead. Lead. I will follow.
Show me. I hope this chase will catch us a plump hen.
Once the abbot has Tedman's gratitude, he will deliver Fulke. It will cost us nothing more than this.
If that leaden wit keeps his word. I'll be gentle if they spot me.
You prefer to work in the shadows.
Get back to work! Time is coin and you're spending mine! Do you dare to question the orders of the great Thane Tedmund? I will have you flogged!
You have the
Come on, you lazy hounds! I don't pay you to lollygag! I could throw a stone and hit a dozen men who'd do a better job than this.
Murdering heathen!
Thank you.
your attention here.
Listen, be razzle! Flay off! Shoot the fundiath or the wearers are!
I am not who you think I am! Let me go!
Stop caterwauling and you live.
Live? Oh, saints, protect me!
Silence will save you, Tidmund. Silence, not your saints.
Flee, my friend. We have the man we came for. Does this fetch
you? You don't prefer working in the shadows.
So we have. To steal a man, take him with swiftness, escape without anyone on our heels. We hide in plain sight. Such is our way. But only until the moment of success, the final strike.
I prefer to act and speak plain. Kings and lords who do not are often misunderstood.
Yet as a leader yourself, you cannot deny that subtlety and intrigue are a cloak you must wear. How many of your clan know the true circumstances of Sigurd's absence? You see my point. A leader must know when to speak and when to stay silent. For silence is not always a lie.
It can feel like one. You...
Halt, Danes! In the name of Alfred, King of Wessex, I demand you release his royal subject into my care.
Come no closer, Christian, else your man dies by my blade.
Please, I'm not the man you want.
Keep your eye on this one. He'll be worth a hefty bounty.
Any false moves and I will snip your heels.
We have your man. Now let's finish this shadow play and be gone.
Are you sure that's Tedmund? He's dressed as a lord, but that man is shorter and fatter than I recall.
I'm not Tedmund. I'm not. I swear upon the holy rood, I am not Thane Tedmund.
What in heaven's name is happening here?
Who are you? Speak quickly or I'll slit your throat and leave you for the crows.
Shergar. I'm called Shergar. Lord Tedmund pays me a measly coin to serve as his double.
Brother Shergar? You are far from Augustine's priory.
I left the cloisters many moons ago, Your Holiness. The monastic life was not my calling.
Rue's sister is our only path forward, whether by stealth or force. Shergar, has the fortress any weaknesses? Any breaches or water wells we might use?
I couldn't say. I've only been there once. But Tedmund has holed himself in its keep, and that's all but impregnable.
You're of no use to us, then. Perhaps I should just kill you, here and now.
No, wait. Let me think. Let me think. Danes! To storm the walls, you need Danes. There's a raiding camp west of here I was told to be wary of. Acting as Tedmund, I ordered a band of soldiers to capture them. If you hurry, you may be able to stop this.
If another band of Danes wants to join our assault, we'll have the distraction we need to get inside Rucester.
If the Saxons don't slaughter them first.
I am still Tedmund to the men in the field. I could speak with their captain, send his men away.
It's a fearless plan.
The Nornir knit winding paths that cannot be unknotted. It seems Rucester was always in our path. Abbot, stay alert. We will send word when we're ready to capture Tedmund.
And this fool? He knows much of our plan.
He'll come with us, and if he betrays me, I will roast his balls over a roaring fire.
You will not regret this. My wily ways and quick wit will cease the need for bloodshed.
I still might kill you yet, man, if your prattling doesn't cease.
The rewards for being Tedmund are rapidly diminishing.
How does one become a double? Are there vigorous challenges and tests to overcome?
I was born with the misfortune of looking like someone else. I should have stayed on God's chosen path,
What took you from it?
I'm the seventh son of a poor farmer. And not wanting another mouth to feed, my father gave me to the monks.
The cloistered life did not suit you?
I thought there would be great comfort in repetition. But instead I found nothing but prayer and back-breaking toil.
The Norns weave strange destinies. Now your life depends on the story you weave for yourself.
I am not a good forgery. Stilted, leaden, my hands sweat, and I have a stutter when I'm nervous. But I will try.
Ah, the cornerstone of all great art.
The captain does not know Tedman well. If we keep our heads, he will not question my orders. I hope.
Those who remain must be saved, whatever the cost.
Let us approach the captain with caution. He drinks too much and does not need a reason to kill us. Yes, it is I, Thane Tedmund, coming to discuss the orders I gave to you not one day ago.
This Hancock will get us all killed.
You will not see another sunrise, swine balls!
Put down your dogs! You're slaves of Kent now!
Thane Tedmund! What are you doing here?
How dare you address me in such a defiant manner? Do you not know who I am?
You are Tedmund, as I've said. And I mean no disrespect, Lord. But I was told you were back in Rue, sister.
Oh, yes. And do I look like I'm in Rue, sister?
You, do not, sir.
A wise man is always unexpected.
You travel in strange company, Lord. An Arab and a Dane.
I'm here to advise your Thane in the ways of my people.
That is correct. A cultural exchange of sorts. Perhaps one day I will visit your Daneland.
Norway. You mistake me for a foreigner, but are we not all just a measure of the places we have seen?
Right. Well, that aside, have you any further orders, Lord?
Yes. I order you to stop loitering and return to your barracks, you scabwit.
And what of the captured Danes?
You must kill them all! Every last... Sorry, no. Leave them here, tied up, as a feast for wolves and crows. That is all. You may depart. Shoo!
A convincing ruse that has earned you your freedom. Go, and make your life anew, not in another man's boots.
I will. This small sup of power has got me thinking. Perhaps I could be a leader of men. Yes! Hurry along, men! Warm thighs and ale awaits!
Come on, you laggards! You have Tedman's orders.
I need to free them.
Norns, weave you well.
We owe you our lives, friend. These Saxon whore sons would have killed us all.
Yes, they would have. And now's your chance to hit back. March with us on Rochester, and drain it of riches.
I would gladly, friend. But we few will not break those iron-thick walls.
And we have no allies in Wessex. None who could be called upon to attack their countrymen.
Mercia will heed the call. Giedrich will provide our Vikinger hort. We'll send a message to Oxenfordshire. The men of Mercia would gladly take a swipe at Wessex. What is your name, warrior?
Runa Egilsdottir.
We need ships, Runa.
We have a small fleet moored upriver, but a naval chain blocks passage to Rusister's walls.
I'll remove it, and your people will bring their ships. Now, gather these fallen weapons and armor. Giedrich and the men of Oxenfordshire will need them to hide their Mercian origins.
My warriors were denied Valhalla today. I cannot bear the idea of gifting their weapons to more Saxons.
Their sacrifice was great. Their gift will be all the greater.
And they will know justice with our victory. It will calm their restless shades, I promise. Will your men bring the armor to the battle?
And what is our plan?
In the morning you will go to Buckingham. Remind Giedrich of his promise. When you have his bond, meet me on the shore near Rusister with the ships.
Abbot Cunibert must be warned in advance. He'll need time to muster his rescue party.
Runa, that is your task. I'll tell you where to meet him before you leave.
All seems in order. At first new light, I will leave.
Good. That gives us time to drink.
You travel so far to carry out your duty. Is this the life of a hidden one? Always on the move?
No. Mine is not the usual path. The Creed does travel. Our ideals are universal. We believe that.
So there's nowhere you call home?
No place I call home. No.
Weird.
For me, home is family. But I have no family.
No one? Not even Hytham?
Parents, brothers, all dead.
I lost my parents when I was 9 winters along. Without Sigurd, I would have. I would have.
There is always one unbreakable bond.
Yes.
Children. They bewilder you. They can cause you so much worry. Fill you with joy. Even stop your heart. And if you're lucky, they replace you. I was not so lucky. I had a son. I miss him terribly. Even now.
I am sorry, Basim.
He was taken from me. By someone I trusted. A friend. A mentor. A man who I would trust with anything. Trust with anything. Can take everything. He took all I had. All I had.
Sister will not be an easy nut to crack. Time to prepare.